Let me start with a story, very interesting story of Muhammad the Pasha, Muhammad Adil Shah. And this is the exact level wherein, like, you know, it was completed. This building was completed till this level. One fine morning, Muhammad Pasha comes and watches the construction, and he is very proud that he is building such a magnanimous building. And he happens to have that that proud feeling, and with that he feels as if I am the god of the whole of the world or something like that. I am very big and I'm more powerful than God. Then suddenly, like, you know, in the night when he goes back home and he is sleeping, and he has this God saying, like, you know, don't be that proud, and the building, I'm going to destroy the building, because, like, you are feeling proud and you are telling that you are the most powerful man on the universe. It is not so. There is still a God, and I'll see to it that your building is destroyed. He gets up and he is like, you know, he's shocked that, no, I did a mistake, terrible mistake, that proud came to me, and then he starts feeling guilty of it. And he runs to his Guruji, Hazrat Hashim Peer, and he wants to have that conversation, what happened. And as soon as he goes to the Dargah, and Dargah, like, you know, the Guruji says, like, you know, you saw the same dream what I saw. And it is shocking for him again. He said, no, Guruji, I was really proud. I am really sorry for that. And I have that guilt feeling that I was feeling that feeling of proudness and all. So Guruji says, no, we will have to come out with some solution of it. And Guruji says, you go today and I'll give you a solution tomorrow. The next day, again, the king goes to the Guruji, and Guruji says, like, you know, it was an utter feeling that you were feeling yourself so big. Now, to your help would come the meagerest thing, like, you know, Hindu mythology, cow dung is very auspicious, and in other way, if you take it, anything which is a shit, and you just touch it, and it is, you would like to just wash it out. So the meagerest thing would help the Pasha. That shows, like, you know, the Pasha is not even equal to the shit. So somehow he says, like, you know, the Guruji says, you have to send an farman to the whole of the dynasty, saying to collect a lot of cow dung. And Pasha does the same. He sends a farman to the whole of the dynasty, saying everybody from the household should collect the cow dung and send it to the capital city. So the whole of the cow dung comes to Bijapur, and it was the quantum of cow dung was enough to fill this square block, which was half built, and to this level, maybe 100 feet from the ground. So they fill the whole cow dung, and the time comes when the meteor was to hit on his building. And yes, to the fact that hits at the center of this building, there was a meteoritic hit which hits in the center, and the quantum of cow dung would, because cow dung is, like, you know, it's having its own properties. So there was a lot of moisture in it. The whole of the cow dung, which was having a density, the meteoritic hit, it absorbs the whole of the shock as well as the heat from the meteor. The meteor cools down and comes to the center. And later on, they remove all of the cow dung and use this meteoritic stone as a najarban, and they tie it in front of Gol Gumbaz so that nobody again has the same kind of feeling, and nobody would give bad omen to the building. So this is a small story which my Dadaji used to tell me, and this is what has to be passed on. The main purpose of this gallery to be constructed, according to my Dadaji, was a spying gadget, actually. And Dadaji used to tell me, like, you know, the king used to get some of the delegates who were to meet the king, and for very sensitive issues, they used to come here to meet the king, because they used to have a darbar in this gallery. And the people used to sit there, and they were asked upon that the king would come in one pahar, and the king never used to appear till four pahars. So that was the time wherein, like, you know, they used to have their own conversation. and like, you know, there was a guard who was standing opposite direction, and whatever they were speaking was recorded in the notes, and then they would understand what, where they good friends or foe or something like that. So that was being given to the king before he used to attend the meeting. So this was like a spying gadget before, like, you know, the king used to understand why the people have come and are they, like, you know, genuine people and are the people. So this is how exactly the king used to manipulate and have a spy gadget fit in and to make out before he meets them. So I think that was a practical purpose of this gallery, which would really give an helping the king to understand if, like, you know, whatever the meetings were to be to come out to a conclusion with these people if they are, like, you know, in a proper way or nothing like that. And you know the acoustical marvels of this gallery, wherein, like, you know, you speak once and you have the voice recalling for 12 times, 13 times. That's it.